Good evening and welcome back to the second game of today's doubleheader against your Humber Hawks and the Mohawk Mountaineers.
Yeah, the first game we saw the Hawks dominate, taking a whopping score 15-0 in four innings.
Yeah, let's take a look at some replays from that first game, from the first one from Jess McPherson.
See it here, it's an outside pitch, and McPherson just turns on it and cranks it over the left field wall. It was gone off the bat.
Yeah, a big hit there by McPherson. Also, Alexis Ferreira in that first game getting her fourth home run for the season. So this is Alexis Ferreira's home run, her fourth of the season.
Yeah, you see it. We said it's a record-setting home run, her fourth of the year. And oh man, was it a shot to remember.
Yeah, this home run making it the most in Hawks history for a softball player.
You see it there, it hits off that back fence. And just off the bat, she knew it. Trots around the bases with ease. You see it there, single season home run record, Alexis Ferreira.
So as the Hawks take the pitch here, Caden Watton will be the pitcher for the Hawks to start this game off.
Yeah, Caden Watton, one of the seniors that were honored in the pregame, as this is her final home game here at Connerville Park. Thank you. See it here again, Caden Watton, third year senior here. She's going to be the starting here for the Hawks. She was honored pregame. As I mentioned, it's her final game here, pitching-wise, at Connervale Park.
So a little bittersweet for Watton here tonight. As that first pitch is a strike.
I'm going to be bunted up the first base line.
Yeah, Oliver right there. Unable to make the play there.
You got to give credit where credit's due. That was a beautiful bunt up the first base line by the Mountaineers.
So the pitch coming now. This one too low. That will be ball one. Another bunt attempt here, but this one rolls back for a foul. Pitch coming now. That one missing high. The pitch coming here, another bunt attempt. Three-one is the count. As that pitch right there will miss just too low. Runners on first and second now. That pitch coming over the plate, strike one. That pitch is just slightly too low, even count here.
Yeah, Watton just missing her spots here. It needs to look to just kind of bear down here, just get back in the zone. Just hit the glove. It's just playing catch with her catcher here.
And that pitch a little bit too low. An opportunity here for the Mountaineers to advance. Runners on second and third now. And the pitch missing inside. And the pitch, another bunt attempt. This one unable to make a play here. The Mountaineers able to score here. First to strike in this game, the Mountaineers 1-0. So pitch coming here. This one to the third baseman, thrown out by Ferreira.
Yeah, that's a great play there by Ferreira. Watching that runner back, keeping her eye on it, making sure another run doesn't score. Great play there by the Hawks third baseman.
And that out will be the first out for the Hawks here. Still runners on second and third. as that pitch coming in too low. Pitch coming now. And this one over the plate. Strike one. The count now 1-1 here. Yeah, gets a piece of this one. This one pops up behind them for a foul. Pitch coming now. This one going straight to Ferreira, and she's there to make that play.
That's a beautiful heads-up play there by Ferreira. Snags the liner and just dives back to third base for the double play. Great play there by the Hawks' third baseman to end the side.
Yeah, let's take another look at that one.
Yeah, that ball screaming off the bat. Liner caught, dives to third base in time. Heads-up play there by Alexis Ferreira. She makes history in the first game, and here she's already making outstanding plays. And another angle here, beautiful. Snag, dive, out.
Yeah, great hustle play there by Ferreira. So Alexa Vassos is going to be leading off the batting order here.
I need to sign up to become an head. I'm killing it out here.
So Alexa Vassos to lead off the batting order here. 4-for-4 in that first game. She was walked twice, getting an RBI single twice as well. The first pitch goes over the plate for a strike.
Yeah, Vassos had a game one to remember. 4 plate appearances, went 2-for-2 with 2 RBI singles, and she reached base all 4 times, twice via a hit by pitch and a walk. As that one's fouled off towards the Hawks dugout. Glad to see we're getting it started early in game number 2 here. Is it empty?
So 0-2 is the count here. As that pitch missing low. Swings high for that one. That one's popped up towards the dugout. Foul ball.
Yeah, Vassos gets another life here as that one just isn't caught over there in the foul territory.
The 1-2 coming now. Gets a piece of that. That one towards left field is caught for an out. It's going to be the first out here for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, beautiful swing there. Good power. And it's a line out to left field there by Vasos. And you saw right there, Vasos and Pasma exchanged a little bit of words, maybe something that Vasos saw the pitcher doing in her at-bat, just relaying her some information.
Haley Pasma here. As she swings on the first pitch, that one's popped up towards the gap in between first and second, but the second baseman unable to make the play there.
Up now is Bree Oliver. Something to take notice here. The four seniors that are graduating.
And that ball is lined towards second base as Bree rounds first. It's a double for her.
Yeah, as I was just saying before, that laser in the center by Bree Oliver. All four batters here for the Hawks. This first four are indeed the first three are the seniors that are graduating. And the pitcher tonight to end it all off is Caden Watton, another senior who graduates.
Alexis Ferreira up at bat now.
History was made in the first game. With her at bat, she looks to continue her pace tonight.
That pitch missing high inside, ball one. Yeah, Ferreira now the all-time leader in home runs for a Hawk softball. As that one line drive to third, a throw is gonna get Ferreira out. Pasma trying to make it home, but she is called out. Those two outs are going to retire the inning here. Mohawk leading going into the second, 1-0. Let's take another look at that. Those big two outs there by Mohawk. Quick throw to first base. Recognition for the runner running at home. And Pasma unable to get there safe. Just another look here. Line drive to third. Quick throw to first. Pasma deciding to steal home. Unable to make it there in time.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. It was a good read there by Pasma. She just couldn't get in safe at home. Hawks looking here to hold it and get back on the offense.
So Madison Young is going to start off the batting order for the Mountaineers here. That first pitch just missing for a ball. Second pitch missing high. That pitch going over the plate. Strike one. 2-1 count here. At that pitch is hit over to Ferreira. She's there to make the play. That's going to be the first out for the Hawks. Another big play by Ferreira there.
Yeah, we saw her make plays before, and she's doing it again here. Great defender there at third. I said it before, that left side of the infield. Should just have gold gloves already.
that pitch going over the plate. Count 1-1 here. A swing and a miss. Watton getting the batter to chase that one. 1-2 count here. That pitch missing inside. Counts even. Another miss on the inside there for Watton. And that pitch is hit towards center field, but that's caught by the right fielder. Two outs now. Randy Dale batting for the Mountaineers here. She's trying to check her swing there, but that pitch traveling over the plate, strike one. Missing just too low. A 1-1 here. A swing and a miss. Strike two.
Yeah, it's a great pitch there from Watton. Fools the batter there. Keeping her off balance. Let's see if she's going to be able to sit her down here.
Yeah, just chasing that one, knocking that one towards the Mountaineers dugout this time.
That's weird. It's a little switch of play there.
And that one gets a piece of it also towards the Mountaineers dugout.
Yeah, two in a row. Maybe this is the new trend of the game. They go to the other side of the diamond now.
Some BP, right?
A little bit of BP. Just foul BP is what it's called.
That pitch coming in a little bit too low here. Count even at two. Pitch comes a little bit too high. Full count. The pitch comes. No swing on that.
That's going to be a walk here in the second inning.
First pitch over the plate there, strike one. So another wild pitch, or a wild pitch there. That one's gonna get a piece of the batter. Runners on first and second here, two outs.
Yeah, top of the order, back up to bat here. Casey Harrison, she bunted in the first inning. It looks like she's going to do it again. That one's going to trickle foul.
Yeah, the Mountaineers changing up their strategy for this game.
Yeah, it appears they're using the speed first. They're not really going for power. They're just trying to get the speed on the base path.
As that pitch a little bit too high.
That's a little bit high there from Watton. It'll be shot just over Ferreira's head.
Fair. Or rolls out. Well, that one is called fair. That's going to be bases loaded here.
Yeah, that ball just going over the head of Alexis Ferreira.
Almost another big play by Ferreira there. First pitch is going to be a ball. A swing and a miss there. It's going to even out the count. Watton looking to retire the sides here. A 1-2 count. The count in Watton's favor here. It's that one missing outside. A swing and a miss. That's a strikeout for Watton. That out there is going to retire the sides. Mohawk still leading this game 1-0. Yeah, another look at that one. Watton throwing that heat. A swing and a miss to retire the sides.
Yeah, beautiful pitch there from Watton to end the side with little damage to almost to none affecting her.
Taylor O'Neill is going to be starting off the batting order here for the Hawks. The first pitch low for a ball. O'Neill connects with that one. That one finding a gap as she rounds first.
That one gets under the wall, and that's going to be a ground rule double for O'Neill.
So Hannah Koziolik now. And she checks that, or looks off that first pitch, ball one. Connects with that one going far left field, but caught for an out. O'Neill is going to stay planted on second. With Jessica McPherson here. Big game for her in the first game. She swings on the first pitch, but that one far left for a foul.
That one was lasered down the left field line. Unfortunately, she couldn't straighten that one out. She's going to be looking here just to wait a little bit more and just pull that one down the left field line fair.
So one out here. Runner on second as that pitch is fouled. Pitch coming now. Also connects with that one, but that one
fouled off. Lasered down there again. And you see, so we talked about in game one, our cameraman down there with some happy feet. This time, standing his ground strong. He ain't moving.
The 1-2 now. As she connects with this one, caught by the shortstop. It's going to be two outs now here. Julie Koss took up the bat. First pitch too high, ball one. It's a piece of that pitch, but that one bounces, fouled. And that pitch coming there, far outside.
Yeah, Kostuck doing a good job there. Watching it, waiting for her pitch. Count is in her control here, 2-1.
Is that pitch called a strike there? Taylor O'Neill able to steal. Runner now on third.
Yeah, great wheels on the base pass there from O'Neill. Getting on her horse and getting into scoring position here on third base.
2-2 coming. Is that one missing outside? Full count now. A swing. She does connect with that one, just going out behind us for a foul. And that pitch is swung on. Kostuk unable to connect. That's going to be the third out for Mohawk there. You take a look at that strikeout. So Kostuk trying to pick out her pitch, but unable to connect with that one. That out is going to retire the sides. Mohawk still leading this game 1-0.
Yeah, unfortunate there for Kostuk as she swings through it, just missing it.
the double R, drop it outside. Check the weather and it's getting real. I'll be outside. I'm gonna drop it. And a view there.
Yeah, it has to be one of the most dangerous jobs in softball.
Yeah. Dangerous job and the dangerous man in softball, our photographer Diego.
As we get started here, Wanton still up on that pitching mount. That's that pitch missing a little bit high and outside. 1-1 count here. A nice pitch there by Wanton. Two strikes. The 1-2 now. Is that one line drive towards first? Stays fair. As the Mountaineers.
That ball's coming in.
Able
play
to,
at third.
To round second, playing at third. But she is safe. A triple here for the Mountaineers. It's a different Mohawk team that we're seeing in the second game, Zach.
Yeah, much more aggressive Mohawk team here at bat.
Is that one just knocked in the near infield, thrown out quickly at first.
That's a big out there for Wanton. As the leadoff triple, the runner remains on third base.
A little word to the batter there.
Yeah, just a little pep talk from the coach to the hitter. They could have a bunt play on here. They could try a suicide squeeze. You never know. That one's fouled off.
Yeah, the Mountaineers definitely wanna score some runs here. So maybe a sacrifice fly ball.
The bunt is on.
Or a quick bunt. The runner at third is going to stay there.
That ball's going to roll foul. It's a smart play there from Ferreira. Letting the ball roll foul. Two strikes now on the hitter. So if she tries bunting again and it rolls foul, she's automatically out.
And that pitch over the plate. It's going to be a strike. Another strikeout here for Wanton.
That's strike three looking. Beautiful pitch there from Wanton. And a great comeback after giving up that leadoff triple. Sits down the next two batters.
That pitch, very nice.
Yeah, she looks poised. She's throwing strikes now. She's throwing with gas.
Yeah, she's definitely in her groove now. Oh, and she gets the batter to chase that one. A swing and a miss. The count in Watton's favor here, 0-2. And that one, line drive to third, stays fair as the throw to first, unable to get that out there. Mohawk scores another run. 2-0 for the Mountaineers. Pitch coming now. That one, great pitch again. Strike one. Yeah, Watton's in a rhythm here. Another beautiful pitch there. as the batter tries to look that one off, but that one sailing over the plate. Strike two.
Ground ball. That one's going to be to second base. Easy flip on to first, and that retires the side.
Yeah, nice routine play there for the Hawks to retire the sides as we get started for the fourth inning. The Hawks are trailing 2-0. Bottom of the third. Julia DeVono is going to be leading off the batting order for the Hawks here in this inning.
Yeah, the catcher, Julia DeVono, looking to get something going for her squad. Sorry for the party rocking. Yeah, you see it here, Kerry Smith, the first-year pitcher for the Mohawk Mountaineers. So far doing a good job keeping this Hawks offense quiet. Well, the Hawks look here to break through.
And a big hit there by DeVuono. That one sails out of this park.
That bounces off the fence.
Or it bounces right off the fence.
Yeah,
yeah. From our angle here, that one looked like it was out of here.
Yeah, it was a beautiful display of power there by DeVuono. And a great start here for the Hawks in the bottom half of the third. Now batting one of the hottest Hawks hitters, Alexa Vassos.
Yeah, back at the top of the batting order here for the Hawks. So she bunts that one, tries to make it to first in time, and she is safe. The throw to first is off, and DeVuono able to score.
DeVuono scores, and Vassos.
Yeah, and she decides to make a run to second.
A great display of speed coming out of the box there from Vassos. She put the bunt down, got on her horse, and hustled to first, making that throwing error happen. And when the error happens, she advances to second while the run scores, and the Hawks are on the board here in the bottom of the third.
Haley Pasma up at bat here as she checks that first swing. Ball one. Humber able to score on that last play, narrowing the gap. A strike on that pitch.
Hey, you see Pasma shaking her head, knowing that knowing that pitch was in a good spot.
So the 1-1 now. As that pitch coming in too high, clipping Pasma.
Yeah, that one's going to hit her on the elbow. Hopefully everything's all good. See her running to first. She looks okay. Good sign there for the Hawks.
Runners on first and second now. Zero out still here for the Hawks. Great opportunity for the Hawks to jump in front of this ballgame. That first pitch is checked, but goes over the plate, strike one.
Now you can see Vassos out there at second base getting a very good lead, making the catcher question whether to throw it down or not. But she's getting a big lead off.
And that ball is connected with toward and finds the floor there. Oliver able to
Vassos on her horse, and she scores standing up. Another great display of speed there from Vassos. Hustles from second on a pop fly, shallow pop fly to center field and scores. And even a great hustle plays on the base paths by Oliver and Pasma advancing on the play. Pasma going from first to third, Oliver running all the way to second. That sets up a great opportunity here for Alexis Ferreira.
So swings on the second pitch there, but that one is fouled out to the left. The game is tied now, 2-2. As Ferreira connects with that ball is going, and that one is gone.
Alexis Ferreira, have yourself a day. In game number one, she breaks the record. In game number two, she extends it. That's her fifth home run on the year.
Yeah, historical performance tonight by Ferreira as she is the history Hawks leader for home runs, softball history.
That was power at its finest. And that puts the Hawks up 5-2.
Taylor O'Neill up at bat here. The first pitch is a ball. That ball connects with it. Popped up. Fouled out.
That one hops right into the ivy there on the wall. That's Taylor O'Neill back up to the dish. She had a ground rule double her last plate appearance.
And that pitch, a swing on, connects, but then a little ricochet goes off of her.
Yeah, you can hear head coach there, Dwayne Bowles, just telling her, walk it off. Don't let the pain sit there. Get the blood flowing.
Pitch coming here, a swing and a miss. And that one is gonna sit O'Neill down. That's gonna be the first out here. Unable to connect with that one, just swinging and missing. First pitch, a swing and a big hit. That one traveling towards the far fence there. Center fielder trying to make a play.
Standing up on third.
Yeah, Koziolek with a triple there.
Yeah, Koziolek there, stand up triple. Beautiful display of power to the opposite field as well as speed on the base paths.
McPherson here, up at bat, big day for her.
Yeah, Jess McPherson, home run in game one, hard contact in her first at bat here in game two, looking to continue the good trend.
Yeah, and a great look off there, ball one. McPherson hitting that one in the gap. Rounding first, a double for her as she slides safe.
The Hawks offense exploding here in the bottom half of the third. Julia Kostuk looking to continue the trend.
That one is going to be fouled back. Runner on second here, only one out. The 0-1 pitch. And that one over the plate, that's going to be a strike. The 0-2 now. As she gets a piece of that one goes towards left field.
Yeah, McPherson's going to be held up at third. Kostuk gets in there to second.
Yeah, great recognition by Kostuk there, rounding first to get that double.
Julia Devano back up to the dish. She doubled in her first plate appearance. Looking to cash in two runs here.
So the first pitch now is she swings on it. That one's going to be fouled back. Hawks in a position to increase the lead here. As that pitch looked good, but unable to connect. 0-2 runs the count. And that pitch too high.
Yeah, Devano doing a good job here in this at bat, working it for her favor. Still down 1-2. But she's fouled off some tough pitches and watched some good ones.
Yeah, good idea to look that last one off. 1-2 is the count here.
Yeah, Devano just calls time here. It's her world, we're just living in it.
And that pitch low and outside. Count runs even.
Two, two is the count here in the bottom of third, one out.
And that pitch also too low there.
Yeah, Devano battling back here from 1-2 to 3-2, counting her favor. Looking to continue to battle here at the plate.
And she connects with that pitch, that one towards left field. It's gonna be caught,
but the runner. Tagging. In there, safe.
So 7-2 here for the Hawks. Yeah, great recognition by McPherson there. Make that run home. So two outs now. That pitch is going to be fouled back. The 0-2 now. That one directed towards the Hawks dugout again.
That one actually lands inside the Hawks dugout.
Yeah, that's a good aim. The pitch comes now, and that one is hit towards left field. Unable to make the catch there, as Vaso is going to round first for a double.
Vaso's using her speed there, getting into the second base as Haley Pasma comes up to the plate.
Yeah, another double for Vaso's there. It's back-to-back doubles. First pitch is going to come in for a ball. ...8-2 now for the Hawks here. As Pasma connects with that one, that one's popped up, fouled behind us. One and one here. And that pitch is gonna go over the plate. It's another strike. One and two is the count here. As she crushes that ball towards center field, hitting the back fence there. But Pasma rounding first. Easy double. Vassal is able to score.
Haley Pasma displaying power. One more push up and that ball's heading over the fence. Unfortunately missing it by an inch.
Yeah, great eye by Pasma. Just picked that pitch out.
And you hear it here. Haley Pasma coming out of the game.
Standing ovation here.
This is her final time walking off the field at Connervale Park.
What a great way to end her career here for the Hawks.
Yeah, great way to end it here at Connervale.
One of bittersweet.
One of the most powerful hitters we've seen in the Hawks history here. A great player. You see her leaving the field with a big smile.
The Mountaineers talking it over on the mount there. So 9-2 here, the Hawks lead. Runner on second with two outs in the bottom of the third. Pasma just calling it a night.
Yeah, getting subbed out there. Beautiful moment. Highlight how impactful of a player she's been for this squad and give her the recognition she deserves.
So Bree Oliver up at bat here for the Hawks. As she does connect with that one towards center field, but that one is caught to retire the sides. So going into the fourth inning, Humber leads 9-2. But let's take a look at that home run by Alexis Vaso's. The one that...
Yeah, we'll see it here. That's number...
Number by Alexis Ferreira.
Number five on the year for Ferreira. As she hammers that one into the gap. And that ball just carries and flies out of here.
Yeah, that home run adds to her Hawks history of being the home run leader of the softball history. Oh, yeah. I think it's safe to say Ferreira is probably the best hitter for the Hawks squad ever.
Yeah, we see it right here. Haley Pasma once again making her exit off the field at Connervale. One of the most premier hitters for the Hawks makes her final exit off of the home field.
Yeah, like I said, it's a bittersweet here. She had a great game, great performance, great season, but that walking off the field there is going to be her last time. First pitch here over the plate, strike one. Connects with that pitch. Grounded. That one, easy out.
Yeah, good play there by Taylor O'Neill to record the first out of the inning.
Pitch coming now, a bunt attempt, but that one just fouls back. So the pitch now, that one, a beautiful pitch there. It's going to be strike two.
Yeah, top of the fourth here, the Hawks are up 9-2. That one's fouled off. I guess that's the first play the trees have made all night.
Yeah, the count runs 0-2 in favor of Watton. As that one goes towards center field, able to bounce, but a single on that play.
Yeah, nice job there by the center fielder to cut it off. Kozielak doing a good job getting over there, cutting off the ball, holding the runner to only a single.
On the first pitch, a little bit too high. And that one hit towards left field, just bouncing past McPherson. Quick throw to third. It's a nice double there by the Mountaineers.
Yeah, Mountaineers looking like they're going to strike here.
Yeah, it looks like they're not going down without a fight.
Yeah, hopefully Watton here can close the door. Number 8, Tomiko Chiba, comes in now for the Mountaineers.
She looks off that first pitch, but that one goes over the plate for a strike. Count runs even here. Another beautiful pitch by Watton there. Count runs 1-2.
Yeah, Watton doing a good job getting the ball over here. Just two runners in scoring position.
That one hit towards second base. A quick throw to first. Unable to make that out as a runner is able to score here for the Mountaineers. The Mountaineers digging into the Hawks' lead little by little. One out here as that pitch is knocked far right and it's going to be a foul.
Hey, you can see there the excited fans for the Mountaineers brought their own
blowhorn,
their own horn for when they score. He's put it to good use here in the second game.
That pitch is going to be outside for a ball. Connects with that one. That one's popped up towards second base. Easy catch there for Vassals. It's going to be two outs now. Beautiful pitch there. 0-1. And that pitch just too low. Count even here at one. Oh, that one is chased. And knocked back for a foul. Yeah, Watton doing a good job of getting the batter to chase that one there. So that pitch is far outside. Beautiful pitch there. That's going to be another strikeout for Watton, three on the night. That out is going to retire the sides. Hawks are leading here 9-3, but let's take a look at that strikeout there by Watton. She's definitely gotten herself into a rhythm. Alexis Ferreira is going to be leading off the batting order for the Hawks here.
Hottest hitter on the day today, Alexis Ferreira, having herself a monumental day. Historic.
Hottest hitter in Hawks history in regards to home runs. Her two home runs today, one in the first game, one in the second game, is adding to her historical performance. Total of 5 home runs for the season. Hawks history in the making. A swing on that first pitch.
Looks like she was looking for her third of the day on that swing, trying to carry the gap even more.
Able to connect with that one. That one finds a gap as she stays at first. Taylor O'Neill here. And Ferreira deciding to steal. She gets to second safe. Okay. 9-3 here for the Hawks, still keeping up with the offensive pressure.
Yeah, they're doing a great job just passing the baton to one another. Looking to keep rolling here.
That pitch coming in for a strike, count even here. Yeah, good decision to look that pitch off. That one is too high. The 2-1 coming. Connects with that one, nice and low. Unable to make it in time to first. That out is going to be the first out here for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, good hustle out of the box there from O'Neal. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to get the first in time.
Ferreira was able to advance to third, now putting herself into scoring position to help increase this Hawks lead. Koziolek up at bat here. As she connected that one towards third base, unable, she gets the first in time. The Mountaineers unable to make the play there. Jessica McPherson for the Hawks. Great decision to look that one off, as that one missing inside for a ball. Another ball here. This one outside. Zach, what do you think Dwayne, the coach, was just telling McPherson? Well, that one is drilled towards right field. The right fielder unable to make the play. Koziolek decides to make a run for third as she is safe.
Yeah, so as you're saying, just trying to tell her, keep your head on the ball. Don't peel off with your swing. And you saw there, she stays down, stays in the zone. Hands go through smoothly, and she's able to hit that in the right field.
So 10-3 for the Hawks here. Runners on first and third. Looks that first pitch off. Ball one.
Yeah, Julie Costa, she struck out in her first plate appearance, but she doubled in her last, drilling a ball to left field. She'll be looking to do the same here.
Connects with that one towards first base. That one's gonna be a single, but McPherson decides to run for third, and she's gonna be safe there. And DeVono up at bat now, the complete opposite of Kostuk, as she doubled the first time up, and she was caught for a fly.
Yeah, she had a sacrifice fly, her second plate appearance.
And that first pitch over the plate, strike one. Connects with that pitch, but that one is fouled back. The 0-2 here. Ball one.
We go two.
another good decision to look that one up.
Yeah, Devono again having another good at-bat, working the count here. She was down 0-2. She's battled back here to 2-2.
Another foul. Great eye by Devono. Still connecting with the ball. Just trying to pick the right pitch. As that pitch sails over the plate, it's going to be a strikeout. So Vassell's now up at bat again, hitting a pop fly. Mountaineers almost fumbling that play, but able to get that out to retire the sides. Had an overall great performance up at bat today, the whole Hawks squad. Performances today by Alexa Vassos, Haley Pasma, and Jessica McPherson.
Yeah, you see it here. The seniors are coming out.
As I've been saying all night, it's a little bit of a bittersweet night for these players, as they had great performances, but it is going to be their last time that they're going to be showing out here for the Hawks Hawks fans.
Yeah, it's a great display here. Great sound from the home fans, giving them the warm welcome and warm goodbye that they deserve. As the seniors hugging each other off the field.
Emotional night here for the Hawks.
Very.
What a great way to say goodbye, though, to have a last game and to just have a dominating performance from your whole team. It's almost like this these two wins today were dedicated to these players. Like Cheyenne Sears will be checking in now, taking over the pitching mount for the Hawks. Caden Watton's going to call it a night with 3 strikeouts. Thank you. Sears gets a shot tonight to show off her talent as that first strike coming in, as that first pitch coming in for a strike. And that pitch, big connection there, but quick single, unable to for the Hawks to make that out. Coming there over the plate, strike two. So 11-3 here for the Hawks. It's that pitch outside for a ball. So the count even here at two. As that one gets a hit towards second. The Hawks unable to make the double play there. But they do get an out at second base. Pitch coming in too low there. The runner on first is going to stay. Beautiful pitch there as that one sails in for a strike. Gets a piece of that pitch, but that one ricocheting and getting a piece of herself. Count runs 1-2. As that swing is checked. The 2-2 now. Beautiful pitch for Sears' first strikeout here tonight.
Yeah, strikeout looking. Two outs here in the top of the fifth. Sears doing a great job coming in relief.
And that pitch just outside. That pitch just outside also. Count runs 2-0 here. As that pitch is connected towards right field, nobody there to make the catch, but just a single there.
Single there by Randy Dale. It's okay though, as Sears has two outs here in the top of the fifth. Only one runner is in scoring position.
Yeah, beautiful pitching here by Sears in relief. As that one comes in for a strike. Just missing inside there. Count even at one. pitch is hit low towards Ferreira. She makes the easy out. And that out's going to retire the sides. The Hawks lead 11-3 as the sides retired here. Big moments in this game. Let's take a look at Alexis Ferreira's highlight.
Yeah, you see it here. Ferreira, her fifth on the year, is an absolute laser into the left center gap.
Yeah, you can see the power on that swing there, just swinging for the fences, and she got it there. Way up and over. 5 home runs for the season for Ferreira. The Hawks history leader for softball home runs.
Batting now for the Hawks is number 5, Megan Muir. Came in as a replacement for Haley Pasma.
Now that first pitch coming in for a strike. It's the first showing for Muir today. She decides to check that swing, but that pitch over the plate, strike 2. The 0-2 now, as that one is going to be hit behind for a foul. That hit there is going to pop fly. The pitcher gets under it. She's there to make the play. So Michaela Tuck now. Connects with that pitch towards left field. That one takes a bounce off the wall as Tuck able to round first, get to second. What a perfect walk-up song for Ferreira. Are you scared? Because I feel like Mohawk should be with the performance from Ferreira today. That pitch called for a strike.
Yeah, we see up to bat here, like you were saying, Rashawn, Alexis Ferreira putting a fear into Mohawk.
She's able to hit that one into a gap there and get a single.
Yeah, great speed out of the box there from Ferreira. We're so used to the big fly, we forgot she can hit the small ones and run them out. Great display of speed there.
Yeah, that hit there, Tuck able to advance to third. Only one out here. Runners on first and third. Hawks with a big lead. That pitch outside.
Hawks are up here, 11-3 in the bottom of the fifth.
The 1-0, that one's looked off.
It's a great eye there by O'Neal watching that inside pitch. It was a good spot, but she waited, didn't swing, and she gets the call.
Yeah, 2-0 count here favoring O'Neal. She gets a piece of that one, but that one fouled back. Pitch now. 3-1 runs the count.
Yeah, count in favor of O'Neal here. You see she's doing a good job not biting at those borderline pitches, waiting for the ball to come into her zone.
And that ball is going to send O'Neal walking to first. Bases are loaded here for the Hawks. Koziolek's going to step up.
Earlier in the game, Koziolek hit a bombshell of a triple to right field. Let's see if she can do it again here.
That first pitch coming in too low. Koziolek connects with that ball, and it goes, bounces off the back. Another run is scored here. Koziolek with the single.
And that ball ripped into left field for an RBI single. Koziolek having herself a day.
So Madison Balzen will be checking in here.
Yeah, she came in to replace Jess McPherson.
She gets a nice connection with that ball, finding open field, able to make it to first, scoring a run here. RBI single.
And that is the game.
That RBI single is going to end the second game in this back-to-back today. The Hawks with a big win.
The players of the game for your Humber Hawks. Number 3, Alexa Vassos. Number 16, Haley Pasma. Number 17, Brianna Oliver. Number 8, Jessica McPherson. And number 14, Caden Watton. And just like that, the Hawks sweep this doubleheader, beating Mohawk 13-3. On a great seniors night, a beautiful ceremony to start off the night.
Yeah, Mohawk came out into this second game striking first, but the Hawks were able to dig in deep, pull and use what worked for them in the first game to pull out the win here.
For sure. I've been Zach Benoit, and I've been here with Roshan Rampersad. We thank you for tuning in, and have a good night.